But the commissioner of the National Football League is going to upload a video at NFL.com/RunRichRun. We'll have to figure out
He's a treadmill guy. He's in the treadmill all the time on the road.
And he might have beat you. And I have been told he is indeed faster than me.
Oh, ooh.
Wow. So maybe that's something for Mike Tannenbaum. Joining us now back in the National Football League as the VP of Football Ops of the Miami Dolphins. You going to put the commissioner on your draft board, Mike?
Yeah, you know, maybe we'll trade up for him and, you know, try to draft you in the later rounds, Rich.
Yeah, I don't know if you're going to be able to fit him under the cap, though, Mike. That might be an issue. He might have to defer. He might have to defer some, you know?
Well, we're always looking for guys to sacrifice for the greater good of the team.
There you go, Mike. That's it. See, now you're back in the swing of things. See, so you've left the agenting behind, right? You've totally left the agenting behind, and you're now an executive VP with the Miami Dolphins. So now when you are in negotiations, you'll be able to look at an agent and say, come on, I pulled that. I tried to pull that a year ago, right? You'll be able to call people out on their stuff now.
Yeah, there's no question. And I'll tell you, Rich, first of all, it's great to be back.
Yes.
And, I did have a two-year sabbatical, and it was great, you know, because I think sometimes in the NFL we get on these trains in the offseason. We go from the Senior Bowl to the Combine, the league meetings, we draft, and next thing you look up, it's 7-8 years, and, you know, to sit on the sidelines for a couple of years, and I tried something new, put myself in an uncomfortable position. I learned a ton and really had a chance to self-evaluate.
Well, what'd you self-evaluate? I'm sure folks in New York would love to know what you self-evaluated, Mike.
Yeah, many of those stories have been written. You know, I think sometimes, like, when you're building a team, you know, there are players that solve problems that you never even know about, and you miss them a lot more when they're gone, and sometimes they can help you as much, you know, off the field as on the field.
Is there one in particular from your time with the Jets that you're referring to in that regard?
You know, there were a couple, but, you know, there were guys like, you know, like Jericho Cottry, for example, like, you know, a really good player that, you know, was great in the locker room. And, you know, sometimes when you move on from players like that, you don't realize some of the other things they can do. And you have to always balance, you know, what's best for the team, you know, in terms of production, what they're doing on the field as well. But, you know, it's such a great sport. And it really does take, you know, selfless teammates to get to where you want to go at the end of the day.
Mike Tannenbaum joining me here on the Rich Eisen Show. Isn't it remarkable, Mike, that you're back in the league with the Dolphins and Rex, the guy, your coach with whom you're most closely aligned with at the time of the Jets, he's in Buffalo. So even when you guys leave the Jets, you don't leave the division. It's really remarkable when you think about it.
And in typical Rex fashion, I ran into him at the Super Bowl and goes, hey, here's the bottom line. We're good friends. I live in Buffalo. You live in Miami. I'm going to come visit you.
Yeah, because of the weather, I'm sure. But the whole idea is clearly to topple the Super Bowl champs within your division. How does one go about building a team to do that, in your estimation, Mike?
You know, Rich, yeah, obviously it's a great challenge. You know, look, the Jets have a lot of good players on their team as well, and Buffalo, I think, was first in the league defensively, so obviously there's, you know, a couple teams that we're going to have to deal with, but it does start with New England. They're not only, obviously, the division champs, but the world champs, like you said, and, you know, you have to try to beat them in all three phases, and they do so many small things well. You know, a guy like Matthew Slater, who's just, you know, so good in the kicking game that, you know, what the plays he makes in space and the hidden yards he creates for the Patriots, you know, they have a great kicker. They convert so many third and short situations that put so much pressure on your defense, and you have to run the ball and control the line of scrimmage. So if you can't compete with them in all three phases, that they are really hard to beat.
I'm with Mike Tannenbaum, the executive VP football ops of the Miami Dolphins right here, former general manager of the New York Jets right here on the Rich Eisen Show. So what is the contractual negotiation status with Ryan Tannehill as we are talking, Mike?
Yeah, well, Rich, boy, we've gone from you know, drafting you and Roger to Tannehill.
Yes.
You know, we're covering a lot of ground here.
That's the way we roll. Come on, Mike. You know, I've got a lot of ground to cover. That's the way I roll, in my estimation.
You know, what we're doing right now is we're kind of assessing the roster. And look, I got a chance to watch the team quite a bit last year. I think Ryan has all the attributes you're looking for. He's young, he's tough, he's durable. Football is important to him, and we're looking at different options and what we should do. And you know, we haven't made any decisions yet, but I'm really glad Ryan's on the team.
And how's it worked with Philbin? I mean, obviously you're brought in. Philbin was already there. The owner, Stephen Ross, is creating a new flow chart in a way. How has that been for you, Mike Tannenbaum?
It's been great. You know, I got a chance to know Coach Philbin, Dennis Hickey, the general manager, over the last year, and they've been tremendous. You know, they've welcomed me with open arms, and, you know, we've had some really good discussions and how we think we can improve the team. And look, Rich, one of the reasons I came here, I don't think this team is far away. I think there's a lot of young talent on this team. I thought they had a really good draft last year, and I really like the quarterback. So, look, with that said, we have our work cut out for us. As you said, you know, we still have the Patriots in the division, and starts with them. So we have a lot to do, but by no means do I think we're starting from scratch.
You know, Mike, the last time I was in South Florida, I did a show from there, and my mobile truck, my mobile unit, the truck got stolen. So we still haven't found the cab portion of it yet, Mike. Can you be my eyes and ears on the ground there to look for the still missing portion of my truck? Mike, can you do that? I know you're a busy man. You got the combine. You have the draft. Is there any way that you could help a guy out all the way across the country? I'd appreciate it.
You know, Rich, I think we need to take this one step further.
Sure.
If we could just get you to broadcast 180 more of those shows from the state of Florida, you wouldn't have to pay any state income tax, and the amount of money we could save you would be tremendous. And we haven't even started talking about the weather yet and that it's 75 degrees, but you're only 180 days away from saving on no state income taxes.
Listen, the weather right now, I don't want to brag too much because there's parts of the United States that's so freezing cold right now, but you know, 180 more days in the state of Florida, I don't think I have enough trucks left to to risk that, Mike. You know,
but Rich, what you would save on no state income taxes would more than offset that.
See, that's now is that the agent in you or is that the general manager team builder in you, Mike? Talking.
100% it's the team builder. When you look at the three other teams in our division and the states that they reside in, you know, we have a competitive advantage in the state of Florida. Not only do we have, you know, the best weather in the country, we have no state income tax. I'm not sure if I mentioned that.
I did hear that. Hey, Mike, thanks for joining. I appreciate it. We'll see you in Indianapolis, okay?
All right, Rich, thanks so much for having me. Great to be with you.
You bet. That's Mike Tannenbaum of the Miami Dolphins joining us here on The Rich Eisen Show.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern. On Audience.